Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to another video on Jetpack Compose. So far, what we have seen is building an application with the lazy column, and then recently we added the scaffolding, that is the top app bar, the bottom app bar, and the floating action button. Now it is time to beautify the overall look and feel of the application. The difference between the two screens is the second screen overall has slightly different look. If you are wondering why, we can just go through a couple of them. The shape of the cards is slightly different. The background colors of the surface that is behind the cards is different. The typography of some of the strings looks different. The colors of the cards is also different. And if you pay attention to the top app bar, the country info app has been implemented using a custom font. So even though the bare structure of the application is one and the same, but the overall look and feel of the application is different. The reason why this is happening is one screen that you are looking at is without theme, and the other screen that you are looking at is with the theme. So in this video, we will get started with an attempt to understand basics of the theming. So let's get started. If you have a look at the structure of the project, it has files such as color.kt, theme.kt, and type.kt. These three are the important files which are mainly concerned with the theming of the application. First, we will try to understand what is the relationship between these three files. Colors.kt contains the configuration about the colors that will be used in the application, and typography.kt contains the typography configuration, that is the font colors, font size, and font family. Both of these two files will be referenced in another file called as a theme.kt. So theme.kt basically contains references to the color.kt and type.kt to basically define the consistent colors and typography configuration for the application. There is one more file which is missing here, which is shape.kt. Shape.kt is once again used to create consistent shapes to be used in the application, and theme contains a reference to that shape.kt as well. We will look at all of these things in a detailed manner. So let's start looking at the code. So this is the application that we have built. This is the country info app scaffold, and that scaffold contains the top app bar, actions inside the top app bar, bottom app bar, and floating action button, and this is the main screen. If you don't know what is a scaffold and why it is implemented, I suggest you just go through the previous couple of videos where I have explained how to implement the scaffold. Now, initially when we started the application building, this is not how our set content code looked like. It was slightly different. What actually was present here was inside the set content, you had country info app theme. And inside this particular country info app theme, you would have written the main content. Now, if I just do this and run the application, you will immediately start seeing the overall look and feel of the application suddenly starts changing. Now, you might be wondering, where is this color coming from? Well, it is defined here in the theme.kt. So in the theme.kt, it mainly contains the configuration about the color scheme, typography, and the content. Content is nothing but the main screen that you added. And this is nothing complicated as much as it looks like. So basically what it does is it takes a Boolean value to decide whether the user has applied the light theme or the dark theme, because based on that, maybe you want to customize which color scheme that you want to use. Color scheme is nothing but these three color configurations, that is primary color, secondary color, and tertiary color. So in the dark color scheme, you want to use different color sets, and in the light color scheme, you want to use different color set. So depending upon what value you return here, you want to use different color set. Dynamic coloring is once again being mainly used in Android 12 and above. Depending upon the surrounding content in the card, you may want to decide what color you want to use. That is where the dynamic coloring is used for. If you don't want to use it, you can basically make it false, and then content is your actual thing. And then this contains some logic what you want to do with this. If you are getting confused with this, what I can actually do is create a custom theme. And once again, in Jetpack Compose, the way you create a theme is as if you are creating a composable, because even theme is a composable. So let me write composable function, my custom app theme. We will pass the same things here as well. Maybe I don't need this dynamic, and then that's it. And here I want to use color scheme dark theme. If this is true, then you want to use dark color scheme, else light color scheme. And then I want to return a material theme, and this material theme should contain these three things. So let me copy paste these three things, and now I can actually use this theme, that is my custom theme, in my main activity and import it. And now if I run this, now I have my own theme. And if you go to my definition of light color, primary is purple, secondary is purple gray 40, and tertiary is pink 40. So if you are wondering where this is defined in color.kt. So there are three sets of colors defined for the dark scheme, and another three set of colors defined for the light scheme. And depending upon which scheme is used, you want to basically set a particular color to the primary, secondary, and tertiary. And what I basically did is put this particular theme as a container to my actual content of the application, which is the scaffold, which in turn contains the lazy column. So in this video, we just basically understood how to create your custom theme and then how to use it to get started with your own basic theme for your application. In the next video, we will have a look at how to change the typography of the strings in the application. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.